get this giant goat. I'm a dingus. I'm a complete dingus. I can play it. I have it. I have the perfect hand. And I didn't even see it. I planned for this. And then I didn't even see it. Okay, this is amazing. Wink. Take that action, yes. Timmy! 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 We are playing a mono green deck today. A Timmy deck, yes! But one of my favorite decks ever, honestly. This deck is super fun and mono green. How is that impossible? We don't even play Nissa. What's going on? We are synergizing the entire deck around the Great Henge and Return of the Wild Speaker. Two cards which kind of incentivizes you to play big, big dudes. Big Timmy dudes. Buff them up to insane proportions and get some insane benefits for this. So the Great Henge costs X less to cast, where X is the power, greatest power among creatures you control. So of course you want to have a huge creature. If something has power 7 or more, then this will cost 2 mana to cast, which is pretty good. Add 2 green mana to your mana pool and gain 2 life. And whenever a non-token creature enters the battlefield under your control, put a +1/+1 counter on it and draw a card. This synergizes, of course, amazing with Growth Chamber Guardian, because you're gonna search for another one, draw another card, search for another one, draw another card, and another card, and another card, until you have all of them, essentially. So how do we get this bad boy down? How do we get the Great Henge down? Well, we have Titanic Growth and Giant Growth, along with Lovestruck Beast and Yorvo. So if we have one of these creatures down, even a Loaming Shaman is good enough. If we have one of them down, we can just plus them so they get 7 or more power, and then we put this down for 2, and then hopefully we start the Growth Chamber Garden loop, or we put down a Barcatrol, which is another thing which is nice to have extra counters on. And that, I mean, is pretty much the deck. We also have Return of the Wild Speaker, which is kind of a backup when we don't draw the Great Henge. Because we can draw cards equal to the greatest power among non-human creatures you control, which means they can draw an insane amount of cards if you Titanic Growth something or Giant Growth something. We also have Vivian, which can deal with flyers, because we don't have any great way to deal with flyers. And we have Loaming Shaman, because yes, we're gonna draw so many cards that we're very likely to mill ourselves. It's actually a concern with the deck that you often mill yourself. That's pretty much deck. Let's jump into it, shall we? Maga, the Rotten One. Rotten One, that's not the nicest thing to call yourself, I don't know. I don't know. You're not that bad, Maga Rotten. Please, don't hurt yourself. Don't look down on yourself. Have some self-esteem. That's what we need. Some self-esteem. Watch other people on them Instagrams. Whatever, I don't know. I'm such a grandpa. I've never used Instagram. I've heard about it. Yes, of course I have. Frack you, honestly. I guess Loaming Shaman, guys. This is more of black, though. It's beautiful. This right here, ladies and gentlemen, is beautiful. You are beautiful. Yaruk Fenlurker. Oh, wait. Yeah, I thought he was... I thought we weren't in the blockers, but we had passed that. Okay. Okay. God damn it. Sure. It's fine. Just gonna find another one of these. Another one of these bastards. Gonna find him. And then we goddamn gonna end the turn. Pass. Full control. Go out of full control. Okay. Fenlurker number 2. Fenlurker number 2. What is gonna go where? What's gonna go? Loaming Shaman number 2, I think. Mm-hmm. And then, Mister. Let's see here. Go in with Growth Chamber Garden. I will deal some damages. He doesn't even block. Takes it! Okay. Growth Chamber Garden. And Lovestruck Beast Token. Now... we don't have a good opportunity to play the Return of the Wild Speaker, honestly. Not super duper good, I would say. Okay, now he wants to cash in, huh? This guy. Well, it's unfortunately a human. Could buff them all, I guess. I think we go in, and then I not decide in a moment, depending on how he blocks it. Probably just takes one on each, right? Do I clear the board here, or do I draw a gazillion cards? 4, to be more exact. Yeah, I mean, this guy's not a trample, so I'd rather draw 4. I could have done that, you know, at any point, I guess, but... Now I did it! Now I really did it! Really did draw those cards. Yep, he draws 2. He's under a little bit of pressure, honestly. A little bit. I have a full grip of cards. Mm-hmm. Yorick's Fenlurker, coming back here. Might lose my Forester. Might lose it. We'll see. Okay, Yorick's Fenlurker. Yeah, he's coming down. The Yorick's Fenlurker deck. Fortunately for us, we have a lot of draw cards, though. So, I think we'll be alright with this. But we have a lot of buff spells. Let us think here. Let us think here. We'll go in with both there. And see what it does. He'll block there. And then just take it. I guess then I'll adapt this guy. Adapt him. Find another Growth Chamber Guardian. Crank. And then... I'll just deal damage. Oh, could I have killed him there? No. How much damage? Oh, I did have lethal. Okay. I did have lethal, but... I decided against it. Didn't feel... no. Didn't feel perfect at that moment. I felt like... Maybe. I need to wait one turn before I kill it. No freaking way you turn this around. No, no freaking way. My mistake! Costing me here! Okay. Yeah, it seems... Seems like we're in a bit of a pickler. We can, though. This is some nasty stuff here. Okay, we can put down the Lovestruck Beast. And if this guy, by some miracle, survives here... we can draw a silly amount of cards to return to the Wild Speaker. Oh, if he survives, though. Okay, Call Room Familiar. That's absolutely fine. Okay. Yorick Fenlurker, though. Okay, no. Place that first. Then Yorick Fenlurker. Yeah. So I think here a Titanic Growth can go. Yeah, resolve. Resolve. Titanic Growth. Okay, so we can draw 8 cards. That's a decent amount of cards, I guess. My turn. Or they can't attack in. Let's see here. Giant Growth. On you. And draw cards. Okay, now we're getting the hench, at least. Now we're getting the hench. Okay. We'll pass Turner. Pass it. And discard 2 forests. It's a little bit late with the hench, unfortunately. I mean... We'll see. Unfortunately, both our Loaming Shamans are... we just went away. Okay. Now we might turn it around. Still have some real comeback potential. I think one of the great henges can definitely go. Don't need all of them. Definitely don't need all of them. And Order of Midnight. Can't block. But he can go in if he wants to. Will he though? Stays back. Lovestruck Beast. Holding back a gazillion. Gazillion units, sir. I think we start off with the Giant Growth. On this. Then, let's see here. The Great Hench. Pretty sweet. Then, there is the question. There is the question. Do we go for our entire library here of cards? We will take a little bit of damage then. Could also go for Yorbo, which I guess is the safer player. Yeah, I should probably go for this. Because next turn I can go Titanic Growth anyways. It's an encounter. Could play another Great Hench. I guess. Doesn't matter if we play it. Sure. So we can gain a little bit extra life. Keep you. And pass the turn. Pass the turn, I say. Unfortunately, Lovestruck Beast can't attack in, but I think we have a decent shot at winning this. Maybe even a good shot. So we can recur the deck one more time. The only thing we need there is Vivian, essentially. Order of Midnight, though. It's gonna be annoying. Fortunately, we have the Great Henge, so we can gain some life back every turn. Okay. And okay, my turn. Gain 2 life, my turn. Let us see here. So we can draw quite a lot of cards here. This guy gets huge. Huge, I say. Huge. Draw cards. There's gonna be a lot of cards. Lot of cards. Oh, now we have the Vivian. Now we have the Vivian. So now we can start shooting down if we want to. Oh, but it would be so nice with a Loaming Shaman. I guess we start off... We could also go in. Yeah, if we go in there... If we go in there... It's a lot of trample damage with Yorbo. And he can't kill it with the Orders of Midnight. He has to go in with a lot of stuff still. Could also kill one Order of Midnight. Or could kill a Midnight Reaps, I guess. That's one way of doing it. Nah, I feel like Yorvo gets absolutely ridiculously huge and goes in there. I think that's how we do it. I can also wait with this when I think about it. And give him trample next turn. Yep, he has trample. Stomping time. You need to block now. Mm-hmm. He needs to block 11, so he needs to really go in with everything on the blocks here. But if he goes in with everything, then he dies, honestly, from the damage. This is 4 damage, 5. Oh, he's dead. You can't block like this, mister. You die! Oh, but how is he gonna block, though? What a pickle! And Midnight Creeps on low life. Oh! How are you gonna block, mister? There's no good blocks. There's no good blocks here. You can't do it. Okay, he had lifelink there. Okay. Oh, he's gonna get... He gotta get the death touch. I know. Does he survive from this? No. He can't, right? Oh, actually can. Because I didn't kill the Midnight Reaps. Why didn't I... Oh, because I didn't reorder the tree. Oh, because I didn't reorder. Oh, I didn't reorder. Oh, God. Oh, he dies, though. That is perfect. He dies. He dies anyways. I'm a dingus. The ups and downs, the emotions there from me. No, he dies. No, he does not. He dies. He does not. That was a good... Amazing, man. Man, triple Lovestruck Beast. Return of the Wild Speaker. It's gonna be amazing. Ace Hiken 94. 94, do you remember 94? It's about when Magic was released. So it's a good year. Wait, 4 years? Diablo 2 was released. I think it was 98. Was it 2000? I don't know. I remember the graphics were a little bit dated already when it came out. Man, my nose. When I look at some of my episodes, I... realized I had a thing for scratching my nose. Really have a thing, bro. Yeah, Lovestruck Beast, Lovestruck Beast, Lovestruck Beast, Lovestruck Beast, Lovestruck Beast, Lovestruck Beast. Man, if you have that finale card, I'm gonna be so goddamn sad. I wonder, because sometimes when you have these weird starts, I don't know. Does the Shuffler rig it so that they have that card? I don't think it does. But I love conspiracy theories. And so... do I push in for a little bit of damage here? Yeah, sure. Why not? Why not, I say? Maybe I should have gone for Yorbo when I think about it. Nah. Ah. Lovestruck Beast. Goes away. Goes away forever. Well, now I don't think I go in, though. Now I think I just... do I go for Yorba? Instead of Lovestruck Beast? Maybe. Nah, Lovestruck Beast has more power. Let's go for this. Because then we can return the Wild Speaker next time. Now I don't want to attack him. It's fine. Man, these lands are beautiful, honestly. Really beautiful. Must say. I kind of like the fertile lands. They look good. Look good. Ace hiking 94. Staying upper. Unfortunately, these are humans, so it won't work with the return the Wild Speaker thing here. Go in. Might book a 1-1. Sure. I think we're fine drawing, but we can draw at any point. We don't need to draw now. Shmink, shmink. See though. For the manas. Just goes. Passes. Okay. I think about this a little bit risky, because he might have a removal spell here. And then I'll draw one card. Okay, I think I'll go to my turn then. I don't want that to have happened. Let's see here. Let's go in with Lovestruck Beast. See what he's doing here. What's his thing here? Going with this. Probably has a removal spell. Some sort. Yeah, I'm happy I didn't play Return of the Wild Speaker. Should have played during my turn. I wasted my entire turn doing nothing. So that was a mistake. That was a big mistake. How do we put down this? We put down this. And next turn, we can draw 6 cards. We can play the Lovestruck Beast 1-1. And then another green. Oh, we have another green creature. Ah, it's a white creature. It's a white creature. God damn it. It's a white creature. Okay, now we can do Return of the Wild Speaker, though. We can even do it in response if we want to. We'll go in with these guys. Smack and smack. See if it takes it. I don't think it takes it, but if it takes it, we could just buff him up and kill him. Mortifies that. I think I do this in response. I think I do this. Yep. Draw. And then we deal that damage. Dish out all that damage. Let's see. Schmick. And then we can play Forest. And question becomes, do we put down a 1-1? Yeah, why wouldn't we? No reason not to. Clink. And your turn, mister. Ace hiking 94. I think you're in trouble now. I think the green menace is gonna get to you. All those Lovestruck beasts, huh? A little bit too strong. Too much muscle. Well, let's see here. We start off with the Great Henge. Which he hopefully can't kill. He has Mortify, but except for that. And then we go in with this guy. We can go in with everything. Pushing for a little bit extra damage. Yeah, let's do that. And see what his response is. Murderously rides the Lovestruck Beast. Do we draw 5 in response? I think we draw 5 in response. Draw 5. And sure. And then, oh, we can Giant Growth there. Okay, Giant Growth is amazing. Yes, this time I'm not gonna miss lethal. Okay. I really hope you restore the connection now. Wizards? Bosco, our next opponent here. Hopefully. Okay, we have 3 lands. Keep this. I don't think I'm gonna keep a 2-lander again. We've got a land sold 2,000 euro. Okay, that's not too bad. I over-exaggerated a little bit. It's only 2 times that we got mana screwed. And that's fine. That's fine. Do we bark in with a troll? Or do we grow to Chamber Garden? I think we grow to Chamber Garden, honestly. Reason being. Yeah, what is the reason? I don't know. I think about it, probably be a better with a troll. Ah, well. Whatever. Yeah, that thing sure dies. Dies a lot there. Well, I think we just go in, smack him, and search for another growth chamber. I think we do that. I think. I don't know if this is the best way to do it. I will see. Need to find another forest, though. That will be quite crucial. Back you, you have 2 legions. Okay, well. Well, you can't win every time. Sometimes you have to lose to win. Snooze, you lose, you win. Wow, you, mister, you only run removal. Removal spell, removal spell, removal spell. There's a lot of people who actually, I think, only run removals in their decks. You have like 20 cards, which are removal cards or something. 20 to 30 removal cards. 20 lands and, I don't know. Hope to win somehow that way. Sometimes it works out for them, I think. Yeah, I think it is. I think it is. Bless you. And listen to the sounds of the world. Submit 0. Maybe I should have gone for the bark control. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe. The thing is, I want to go quickly up so I can do -5 on this thing. Because that would be amazing, of course. Hopefully it doesn't have yet another Murderous Rider. Could have. Oko. Bound of Thorns. And a Gilded Goose. Well, he can't easily trade. Luckily here. Could go for the food token and exchange next turn. I guess he could do that. Okay, or turns that into a 3-3. That's decent, I guess. Well, it's not amazing. Not amazing. Wait. We could buff this up to 6 and kill Oko. That's probably what you should do, right? That's probably what you should do. You. You. Kill him! I don't like him. I don't like him one bit. And then... we'll do a Lovestruck Beast token. Yeah, I think we go in with the Bark Control. Go in with the Bark Control. Just bark in. Oh, wait. I can't. Can't because I skipped my attackers? Did I skip my attackers? How did I play this? Why did... oh, yeah, I know. Okay. It fights the Bark Control. The 1-1. Just die to the Bark Control. Could do that. I guess. Yeah. Dies to that. We block with a 1-1 here. It goes in for Vivian. Yep. We gotta protect our Vivian at all costs. At all costs, I say. This is pretty sweet. Because now we can do this. Get the 2 counters on there. Smirk! And get another Growth Chamber Garden. Now, I think we do it.
My.
Take an action. Swing. Put you down. Put you down, I see. And pass turn. That's pretty sweet. Hopefully it doesn't have yet. Man, this guy runs removal. Wicked Wolf, Legions, and Murderous Rider. I think that's not all. I think he also has Ritual of Soot. That's what he said. Cry of the Carnarium. Probably is in there. Something else. Also. Okay. Sovereign and free. With a food token. Okay. We can't kill this guy. We want to. Can go in with Growth Chamber Guardians. And if he doesn't block, he loses everything, essentially. He needs to block them. That should be good. That's one green, though. We can do something with that, maybe. Something, something. Something, something, something. Mm-hmm. Well, let's think about this. I'm gonna plus this in any case. Yep. Give them... Oh, I should have put two counters on this one, I think about. Oh, it's fine. This will be fun. It's fine if he blocks her. We'll have to decline this. Decline? Because there are no more growth chamber guardians, unfortunately. If we could shuffle them back into our library, that would be pretty sweet. Going for Oko. Oh, I could have gone face and killed them, couldn't I? Yeah, probably. Could have gone face and killed them. Again. Gun missing it. Let's see here. We need a little bit more damage to kill Oko, though. So, let's see here. Ah, buff this up. Buff this up, I say. This is one. Yeah, he's dead. Oko is dead. Wink, wink. And every creature has. Not fair. Well, I could have killed him also. That would have been easy. Again. I know, I'm not used to playing with these guards. I blame that. You know, I blame everything. But it wasn't me. Not that I, you know, misplayed. Really. No, that wasn't the case at all. My turn. Ooh, this is pretty sweet. Lovestruck Beast. And let's see here. Put two plus counters on there. I don't think we need any Lovestruck Beast. Ah, this is fine. We need the Hench now. The Hench would be amazing. Tackle action. Decline. And go in. The Hench or the draw five would be amazing. Or draw, how many cards will... this won't be too many. Five cards. That's seven. We're gonna actually draw seven with this. If we get the nuts. The nuts. Okay, now he's dead though. No, because we can't go in with this. Got him. Got him. Got him, got him, got him. Again, the emotional roller coaster. You go first. I'm not gonna fall for these freaking two landers. I'm gonna mulligan. We're gonna find the creature. We're gonna find the creature. This is not the best event. Let's hope we find a creature. Okay, Love Truck Beast. That's perfect. That's exactly what we needed there. Okay. And pass turn. Can Giant Growth this if he goes for a disfigure here? Probably doesn't, but he could theoretically do that. Okay, luckily we have two Loaming Shamans in the deck. So we might... Oh, he mills himself. Interesting, okay. Very, very interesting, sure. Put down this. And no attacks. Hopefully we'll find our land there. Fourth land. Great Hench, Growth Chamber Guardian. Ooh, that would be so good if we could get that up. Okay. Middle, 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 middle. Okay, well, that wasn't really... I didn't really get that thing. Well, we can go in with these, and we can maybe kill both his walls here. With the Giant Growth. Oh, wait. If I buff him up, I can play it. Okay. I can just Giant Growth it. I'm a dingus. A complete dingus. I can play it. I have it. I have the perfect hand. And I didn't even see it. I planned for this. And then I didn't even see it. Okay, this is amazing. Wink. Take that action, yes. That's a pretty sweet start. That's a pretty sweet start. When you get this down, turn 3, turn 4. You're in pretty good shape. You're in pretty good shape, I say. We can draw a million cards from this, if we want to. Do we want to do that? We can go in first, though. Win first. Oh, this guy's mana screwed. Ah, god damn it. Actually, I know this sounds like a lie, but actually wanted a fair fight. That's such a good stop. Oh! Don't get mala-scooed. What a fight, goddammit. What a good-ass fight is what I want. Because this is so freaking good. Oh my fucking god. This is good. Thank you, action, yes. And yeah. Yeah. Decline you. Decline you. And we're even gonna go for that one there. Problem? Use? Problem? God damn it. I got the mana scooter. I wanted a fight! God damn it. Morals! Do you have morals? I have no morals. I can do anything I want. I'm a free human being. Not a bite to human morals. I know it's spelled differently. Where is it? I know it is. Morals! What will he do here? What I wonder. Okay. Well. Let us see here. I think... Just put down your boy, honestly. Put down your boy. Well? No, this is actually perfect. It's actually perfect. Because next turn, we go... Titanic Growth. No, don't get land scoon. Why does everyone get land scoon when I have an amazing hand? I don't like that. I know it sounds weird, but I don't like that. I don't like it. When? When they have a bad hand, when I have an amazing hand. Because I just win like this. I want them to have a good hand, and me to have a good hand. Can that happen, please? Please? Blinks? He's so dumb. He's so dumb. Savio. The savage. The savioche. Yeah, I know. I should just stop. Stop. No creatures. But we have a lot of creatures in this game. We're gonna draw one. 100% gonna draw one. Very soon. Hopefully. Come on now. Deck. You really need me. Yes. And please don't kill this. If you can avoid it, Sabio, don't kill this. Dorks, Fennec. One great hench can definitely go. Don't need them in the doubles, I feel like. Don't need them in the doubles. Okay, so here then. We can buff this up to 5. But that won't be enough to play the hench, so we go in with Goat Chamber. Guardian, he just takes it, we buffed up the 4, find another growth chamber. Take that action, yes. Find another one. Which is pretty perfect, because next turn we can go giant growth on this guy, and the great hench, and go to chamber garden, which is amazing, if he doesn't kill it though. Okay. And play growth. God damn it. God damn you. Oh well. Well. Hopefully doesn't have one more of those. Hopefully. Rolic Banner, that we can, you know, survive. That's fine. I'm gonna take some damage here. Goes in. Nope, my turn, okay. Okay, let's see here. We can buff this up to 5. I think we just do this. Take that action, yes. Go to Chamber Guardian. I think we just do this still. But no, we put on the bark control. We do this. And do we go in? Yeah, I mean this is a pretty good chance to get one of them killed, I guess. I got the dice. That's fine. Hopefully it doesn't kill the Barkai Troll. But it probably does. Probably does. Heraldic Banner. And then... It's pretty good, honestly. Or well, I mean, it hasn't done too much for him. Not a little bit for him. A little bit for him. Now then. Now we go in and buff the troll. Of course. So we can put down... Could make this one cheaper, I guess, with yet another giant growth. Why not? Yeah. Nine? No, it goes two. And... another one of these. Shrink! And take that action, yes. Find another one. Put down this. And do we also put down this? Yeah, I guess so. Why not? Why not, I say. We don't have another growth chamber garden, so we'll have to wait. Decline. And go in with walk control. Unfortunately, we couldn't return to the wild speed goal, so that would have been amazing. Barank! He's down to 7. But he does have a pretty huge dude there, honestly. This guy could get freaking enormous. But on the other hand, we can kill him with what we have on the board, with Return of the Wild Speaker. We could go for the +3/+3 mode. And that should kill whatever we want. Not the Bark Control? No? Okay. Apparently not. Apparently not. Ah, okay. And Light of Death. Cool to see a lot of mono black, though. Must say. We can go in here and buff everything up. Then everything dies. It returns a Fen Lurker or something. Plus draw 3. That's another option. Draw 3 isn't the strongest. But I mean, if we kill these guys... surely blocking with the Cavalier of Night. And he's getting like a Yorok back or something. I think we can push it. I think we can push it and see how he blocks. Okay. There. And that's it. Let's think about this. We can buff this up so that it goes down to 1. But that won't help much, honestly. So I'd rather draw them. That hurts so much! Drawing 4 forests there. Oh! Painful! Painful in every single way, yep. I heals up again. God damn it. Oh, 4 forests, really? That's what's on top. Okay, my turn. Come on now. Five forests. Yep. Really? Oh, well, I could have tapped my Great Henge. I didn't do that last time. It can actually make me survive. Yeah. Sure. Take a little bit of damage. Okay, come on now. Come on now. Ah, we pass turn. We have the Great Henge. Just need something here. Just need something. Something to go our way. Okay. So kill this. Yep. Yeah. Do this thing. To a 7/7. Block this. Dies. It turns something. We're down low now. Come on, man. Not the freaking forest again. I can't take another forest. Yep. Yeah. We'll remove. I know it doesn't do anything. Come on now, deck. You can't draw another freaking forest. Oh. Loser Sep. What am I even trying to say? Okay. Loser's up. He is mulliganing. Did he do it twice here? Twice the mulligan. Twice the dingus. Not the mulligan. But actually, I've mulliganed quite a lot this time. I've become less of a dingus. No. More of a dingus. Only dinguses need mulligans. You're not a dingus. Yeah. Oh, wait. Don't even attack it. Okay. Brains. Brains, I know it's late, but we need to keep it in. Need to keep it. Hold it together now, Brains. As I said, I take no responsibility for my own actions. Never done, will never do. That's good. This guy goes in. I mean, we kind of want to grow this guy, though. So, put him down. See if we can grow him up a little bit. Into the perfect size, maybe. Yorvo, Lord of Garumbrig. This guy doesn't die, then I don't know who dies here. There's a lot of mono black. I think my mono black video got quite popular. I've seen a lot of mono black recently. It's by, I think it's gonna be my most popular video ever. It's gonna be like, I don't know. It's gonna reach 100,000 views, it might. Humble brag. Hashtag humble brag. I don't know, is it? Is it really that popular? Humble brag. Just stumble on my 50-inch dick also. Humble brag. Okay. Loser Sep. Oh, Castle Garenbrig. I think this is the first time we find this. Where are we going with these two? Sure has a removal spell of some sort. Some sort. Will he have? They always have the same. It's always the Murder Strider. I mean, he used murder, so. I wouldn't say it's always this. Yeah, yeah. But it is always. But it is always that thing, isn't it? Isn't it? maybe the Loaming Shaman. He has the same power as this, anyway, so. And now we get the good stuffs back here in the deck. Schmink. And pass turn. It would be amazing if we find the hench here. It would be absolutely ridiculous if we find it. Absolutely ridiculous. See if we do, though. Okay. Loser Sep. Gonna put down here. Nothing. Nothing. Murder's right. Okay. Okay, okay. Well. It's under bar control. That's not amazing in any way. We'll go in with these two. Can kill one with a giant growth. With a giant growth. Blocks there. Just growth it up. Growth it up and kill him. Gets a little life, unfortunately. Unfortunately. Now we need lands. The lands that we... but we draw four of last time. We kind of need to draw them now. Oh, yeah, magic is about drawing lands at the right time, honestly. Like here, this game, if we'd drawn lands on timer, that would have been... It would have been amazing, I say. It would have been amazing. But now we didn't. And that's why we are in trouble. We can draw three with this, that's not amazing. I mean, worst case, we have to do it. Okay. And then... My turn. Okay. Hmm. Yeah, I mean... I'll draw three. That's the only thing I can do, then I'll draw three. Yeah, pass turn. See what it does. We did draw into more Return of the Wild Speaker, though. Okay. Two damage to my face. That's fine. That's a card that really didn't fit into your deck, mister. Everything else looked solid, and then just... well, the murder, I don't know too much about, but the Whisper Agent just feels so out of place here. Loser's up. That's my criticism. That's my banter there. Is that great banter? Now we've seen that too many times now. Let's see, my turn. Okay, okay. Well, this is not the worst. It's actually good. So now we have a 4-4. And we have another Ghost Chamber Garden. Hopefully doesn't have the finale card. That would be
a little bit horrible. That would be a little horrible for us.
So else we can return to the Wild Spigger. Get something going. This is Loser Sep. Black Lance, okay. Target Knight gains Death Touch. Yeah, you sure have Death Touch now. It doesn't matter. That's another card that felt completely out of place there. Okay, my turn. Yeah, I think we just go for it, honestly. I think we just draw. Draw four. Not there. Okay. Another return of the Wild Speaker. Yeah, this is the return return of the Wild Speaker round. Where everything is a little bit slow. I still save it. Still think we say no attacks. This guy hasn't really got much value out of this. Will he draw a card this time? Probably will, right? Has to. Has to be the way. Mm-hmm. Draws a card, loses a life. That guy! We only have one card which can deal with. Unfortunately. Well, we can go in now, I guess. And we can use the third return of the Wild Speaker. Depending on how he blocks, though. If he doesn't block, he surely blocks. Okay. Be there. That's the only block. Might be. Mm-hmm. And there. And nothing else. I think I still rather draw the cards, honestly, than buff them up. Yep. So let's see here. We put down this. Oh, I could have. No, should I have put down the 1-1 first? Maybe I should have. Counter on there. Yeah, I should. No, because it's not green. Ah. Oh well. I can do this at any point, I guess, though. Draw the cards. Yeah, and the turn. I shouldn't behave like a scrub. I should not behave like a scrub. That's what I try to tell myself all the time. Try to not be a scrub. Try to not be a scrub. Okay. You'll still damage to any target. My face. Okay. And goes in with the troops. Whisper Agent, the Spawn of Mayhem, Dread Presence. Everything! Well, there's a block here. Take 7. And then draw an absolute million cards. There's the Great Hedge. There it is. And the way to deal with the Spawn of Mayhem. Awesome. Amazing. Okay. So here then. Kinda want this down. Kinda want this down. And then, let's see here. Put this down. Let's get a little bit of that. Got a little bit of cards. A little bit of that. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. Take action. Okay. God damn it, we drew it from this. Oh, well, well, well. Now we can kill the spawn. Minus. Kill this guy.
We're gonna tear you apart.
We're gonna tear you apart, mister. Gonna tear you apart so much. And we can decline this. And go in for 7. Smack him! Smack a thank you. Losers up. Gutter boners. Mm-hmm. Gutter boners. Gutter boners. I think we do this. We turn everything in our graveyard. Yep. Everything I say. Okay, now we'll draw an absolute million cards from our return of the Wild Speaker. Deck action. Wimp. Fine, let's go. Ah, no, no, wait a minute. Soon we'll find a million cards. This is not it. We have more. Now we're gonna climb it. And we're gonna put on some plus counters on the this guy and this guy. Shmink. But first, I draw a few cards here. 11 to be exact. Got him.
Memory shout out. Memory shout out.
Thank you everyone so much for watching. And a special thank you, of course, to our dear members. Blue Dragon, Owen 77, Adam Alexis, Ramen Noodles for Me, Magic Pistol Man, Simon Lauer, Rodney Cox, Herman M, Agony Reborn, The Soft Pillow, Snick, Luria Stars, Shamanic, Spencer Hofstey, Alex Mike, Nathaniel Nisson, Laser Scepter, Stun Eric 0234, Jeff Henry, Leaning Into It, Santa John, Michael Yu, Pocky Yu, Matthias Porley, Topless Investments, Kronos 1107, W Lutz, 1978, P, Peter Gold, Strange Brontites, Sean Stevens, Gabriel Juvenile, Tundex Smog JC, Marcus Rutledge, Tim Stokes, Wizza, QD Late 23, Brian Gutierrez, Amano 84, Seth Hickok, Way, Ian Cusack, Messamok, Ye Old Basses, Dingo Scrub, Orion SSFL, Crew the Barbarian, Linkus Week, Rainbird 2002, 4K Television, Across Ascending, Yulai Moonlight Star, Donkey Kong, Wilker Ribeiro, Jace Unraveler of Secrets, Carlos Martinez, Drakech 2000, Dave Steer, Nicholas Zanotti, Jurassic Fart, The Swamp King, Wokia Floren, Rage Notch, Simple Human, Badass Winab, Badass Wanab, Aaron Noble, Betsuma, Brandon Dobbs, Callus Dismissal, Sherwood, Caleb, Carlo Palumbo, Dan Goodsell, David Newman, DBK Drummer, Dingo Scrub, Drew Styles, Eventum Tantum, Freeman Stephenson, Jeff Jordier, Kazon, Kip Costner, Magneto, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, Piotr Stolarczyk, Pote, Prince Mark Bagauk Esquire, Rainbow Cake, Serge Karamarov, Wonderbread, and X Covenant X. You guys are amazing! If you also want to become a Dark Disciple, help rule the underworld and all that jazz, then check out either the join button next to the subscribe button or check out my Patreon, link in the description. Thanks so much for watching, and see you next time. People often ask me, are there other people in need of thank you? And I tell them, these guys, the bad shoulders on Patreon, also needs a thank you. Thank you.